Hello, guys, and welcome to another All Balls special. It is I, Carl, again, and today we have a special guest. We have none other, our local lad, Mr. Karan Amin from Jamshedpur FC. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much, Carl, for having me. It's a pleasure to be on the show.
Well, I appreciate you actually taking time to have a chat with us, man. How's it going, though? Lovely weather today.
Okay, man. Like, I've just come back to Bombay, so it's a little hotter here. I was in Odisha all this while.
Fair enough. So, Karan, let's talk about your journey in football. What made you fall in love with the game?
So, actually, I was never a football player at first. I used to play hockey in school when I got in school. So, hockey was my first love, you can say, actually. So, I was playing hockey initially. And then, when I actually joined college, I actually wanted to go to Andrews and get into the Andrews team. And then, what happened is... somehow, because of science and everything, I got into Bhavans, and there was no hockey team in Bhavans. So I decided to try out football, and that's how it all began.
Yeah, I know. I mean, well, what's hockey's loss is probably football's gain. And you played for a lot of good young sides. Like, I mean, you've represented Air India and Mumbai FC. And how has it been the progression before? I mean, I'm sure we're going to talk about your ISL journey. But how has it been from the grassroots level to now?
So initially, I think I remember the first trial I went to was Mahindra's, the Mahindra United team. So that's where I was picked first initially. And you see all these senior team players, Venki Bhai and Mahesh Gavli and everyone, all top in players were in Mahindra United at that time. Even the foreigners, Pareto and everyone, Yakubu. So for us, it was overwhelming to just look at them, you know, and just even Khalid Bhai, who was there, he was playing back then. So to just look at them on the same ground was overwhelming. And from there, Air India called me, so I played for Air India then. And then from Air India, obviously to Mumbai FC, and then that's how it progressed. So it's amazing, you know, because you have your college life and your team to balance. So you have to go to college and then come here. So it's really fun, you know, like I can't explain it because you have to go through it. It's completely different, you know, but it's nice, you know, like there's everything, you know, you have your college life, you have your football. So you have two different groups as well. So it's fun. It's fun. It's really nice.
It's well balanced. Yeah. And it's funny you mentioned Khalid Jamil because a lot of people we've also interviewed in the past who still cannot stop talking about Khalid Jamil, how much they owe their careers to him as well, you know. And I have to say though, now you've been through the landscape of football, you know, culminating with Jamshedpur FC. How do you see the landscape of football changed in India?
Oh, massively, man. So I've been through this phase where I've seen my senior players and the players I've played with become coaches now, like Noel Wilson and Steven Dias and everyone. So even all these guys have become coaches now. And I've been lucky to play alongside them, you know. So I've seen quite a bit. So there's like a huge change. It's become faster. It's become more professional. The youngsters now know what's the importance of diet, good health, the diet. So all these professionalism came in now because of ISL growing up and I-League growing up, people watching a lot of football on TV, and it's very accessible now. Mm-hmm. So it's grown massively, you know, like even if you ask a kid, 5-year-old or 6-year-old kid right now about the Premiership, they'll know about it. Even the Indian League, they'll know about it. And it's not just Chhetri Bhai or just the top players. They know all the guys, you know, no? So it's gone up massively, you know, so it's in a very good way, actually.
Absolutely. I mean, I agree with you. I think Indian football is on the up, you know, and I always ask this to most footballers when I interview them, though, like, I know we're improving. You can see that Indian football is slowly garnering the attention that the world is giving to. But what do you think is right now what Indian football needs to improve more? What do you think would be our shortcomings right now?
No, I think everyone knows about it. It's basically the, if you compare it to a Barcelona, for example, like a La Masia, it's the kids. The kids are going to be the future of football. So now we got it. I got the level of coaching at a very late stage. So if there are kids who can learn this when they are 6, 7, 8 or at this level, it will help them in a longer run, you know, because if your basics are good at 6 and 7, you can be a master at all that when you're 10, not when you learn it at 17 and then master it at 21. And kids are more good at grasping things than when you're older, you know. So I think the main focus should be the youngsters, you know, because they are the future. That's where we need to do that. So.
More emphasis on grassroots football. I couldn't agree more. Like, that actually does make sense because, I think, as you said, if you impair them with the knowledge that you have now for them at a 6 to 8 years level will be invaluable for them, I'm sure.
Of course, of course.
So, Jamshedpur FC, Karan, how was the journey? How was it with ISL and everything? How has it been so far?
Amazing. It might sound like a cliche, but it's like a dream you don't want to wake up from. The only thing tough is you staying away from the family, but that's like a small sacrifice for the greater good. I'm happy doing, every day waking up, going to the gym with the team, with my teammates, having weight checks, having fat tests, this, that, everything, having training sessions, chilling, having doing banter, everything. It's nice. Like I said, you need to be there to experience it.
Yeah. But
it's been overwhelming and really nice. There was a time where I thought I'd never play ISL, because I was getting older and everything. And they were kind enough to offer me a trial. Like, I was there on like almost a 3-month trial.
Uh-huh.
And it finally happened in like Jan, they registered me and everything. So even it's the small things which just build up, So it was good.
Absolutely. And I mean, like, do you have any spot? What would you rate as your biggest memory or fondest memory in football, in professional football?
It'll be unfair to name this one, but I think my professional debut for Jamshedpur FC.
Absolutely.
That would be the best, It wasn't a Super Cup, I remember. It was really good.
Great, great. So now, Karan, we have this little segment in the show we like to call Explainogram. It's just a little fun thing that we like to do, and where we basically pull out a few of your posts from social media. And so you can give us a little bit more detail. So we're just going to run through a few pictures and you can just describe and give us much detail as possible or not much detail as possible. Give it up to you. So we're going to look at the first picture here. There we go. What's happening here? This is definitely a celebration. So,
so this was the final game of the season. So this was after the game against Chennai. So we needed to win against Chennai in Chennai. But unfortunately, we drew against them and we were out of the top 4 because of that. And then it was a final game against Bangalore FC. And we had to do it for the fans, because the fans in Jamshedpur are amazing. Like, you have a sold out stadium every game. So I remember we were down 1-0 against Bangalore. And suddenly second half, I don't know, the coach gave like a pep talk, do it for the people who come to watch you, do it for your family. And he was Spanish, so you know how it is when they say it.
Yeah.
With the emphasis. And we were like, okay. And Cesar Ferrando was the coach, I remember. Top guy.
Yeah.
And we came out second half and we scored, I think, 4 or 5. And this was like a direct free kick. So Carlos is like, he's played in the La Liga. One of the best set piece specialists I've seen. He got the ball top of the D, he scored, and he was really close to me as well. So we all ran behind him.
Let's move to the next one, though. That this is a very special picture. I'm sure not everybody gets to meet a football idol like Mr. Cahill over here.
Tim, so I call him Ledge because legend. He's an outright legend. You don't get to play with him every day, man. Because when he came, when we heard of him coming to Jamshedpur, we thought it's another rumor, because you see it on social media, so many rumors of this one coming, that one coming. And then I remember we were in Spain and he just lands over there and we were like, okay, so it's actually happening. And
it looked like a very aggressive game of rock, paper, scissors there, the two of you.
So what was there, we both were on the bench and we were playing Rondo and we had to decide who had to go in first. So we were deciding. So I think he won that day.
Yeah,
the most amazing footballer I've met, they say it's, I don't know how true it is, but I've always heard the bigger the footballer, the more humble they are. So he's right there. Proper leader.
The legend, sir, Mr. Tim Cahill. And now on this next picture, which I'm about to share with you. Yeah. Now, we were told that this is a very jovial fan over there. And there's a sign in the corner, which I really can't see much, but it's got to do something with that in your WhatsApp display picture. So
give us
more detail about this picture, basically.
So because I've been in Jamshedpur, I've been very social with everyone, with the staff, with the players, with the crowd. I like to interact with people. Because we're in Jamshedpur, we're always interacting with people. we go for fest, college fest, or something or the other. So I think some fan, like, I know the guy personally because he came up to me and asked me for my jersey and I helped him out. But he's been supporting me from day one, I remember. And my bad times, my good times, I always take the picture as an inspiration, you know, because, you know, even if you can inspire just one guy, it's more than enough. So that guy inspires me actually because of that. But absolutely, crowd, like, you know, I said, in Jamshedpur, for the best.
Yeah, something else. Yeah, I mean, and yeah, it's nice how you pointed that out, that, yeah, it's for the fans. Football is always about the fans, you know. And like, I've seen how passionate India are when it comes to football as well. So it's really nice to have fans and someone like that, like, who's like a diehard fan. I mean, we've seen that with cricketers, but you really get to see that with footballers, you know.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So moving on though to the next picture. And yes, so
Pogba.
So that's your dog, Pogba. How many dogs do you have, Karan?
I have just one dog. This is my
just
first
one. Yeah. Okay.
So he would actually be here, but he would trouble me a lot and move the camera a lot, so I kept him in the other room.
Okay. Have you always been a dog person? Like, have you, like, growing up?
When I was a kid, no, we had a dog. Like, my grandpa had a dog. But because we moved houses, like, and our grandpa was in a different house, I didn't get to interact much with him. But whenever I was young and growing up, I was playing with him. But then, you know, when you're a kid, you don't realize much. And then he passed away and everything. But then when I had the chance to get my own dog, I got him. So my mom said no for it. But now she doesn't care about us. She just thinks about him now. So we are just on the side now.
What's behind the name? Is it the love for Paul Pogba or the hate Paul Pogba?
No. It's obviously love. So I used to love watching Juventus play back then when Pogba was there. And I'm not a big Manchester United fan. Like, the people who know me know that. But he was from the youth product and he came from Manchester to Juventus. So I used to just watch football and I watched him play for Juventus. And I was really impressed, you know, like the way he played, the swagger he had, the flair he had. I got the dog, so I didn't want the conventional Tommy or Rocky or this. Toffee or something like that. So I just thought of, so I used to always adore him. And then I thought of him and I got him. And I remember one of my friends, she came down from Italy and she got, like, from the Juventus stadium, a Pogba jersey for him.
That's cute.
It's nice, isn't it?
I mean, not every day can you say that you get to hang out with Pogba every day. So that's kind of lucky for you there, Karan. And our last picture now we're going to take a look at. Oh, this is actually a really, really suave picture. There's Mr. Jayesh and Ashutosh as well. So explain this. Yeah. Karan. So
this was from the shoot at, there was a Hugo Boss shoot. And there's a friend of mine called Sheldon who helped us out. So he had contacted us, and so he contacted Jayesh, me, Ashu, and there were many more guys. Anas Bhai was there, Vineet was there, Rafi Bhai, Chetri Bhai, everyone, all the football, even Robin was there. So we all had, like, slots and everything, but we said that give all three of us, like, slots together. So it's like 4, 5, 6, so we all come together. And I remember there was a photographer called Vaishnav Ravi. So he clicked a picture and there was something candid which was going on. So initially it was supposed to be a single picture, you know, like solo shoot. So because we have, like, a top class photographer, we made use of it and we were like, let's do, like, a group thing. And someone said something and we all looked and then we got that picture. And it came out really well, actually.
It's a very sophisticated look, I have to say. I mean, like, probably there's a modeling contract in there, Karan. I mean, like, you might just have to look that through. Like,
I have to do something with my hair now.
And that ends our segment of Explainogram and where we looked at all your socials. But coming back to the interview, like, I always want to ask you, like, you've always considered Khalid Jameel as one of the people you look up to, and even Owen Coyle as well. Like, how important was he in your development as a professional footballer?
So Khalid Bhai, you could say, was my first professional coach ever. Because I started football very late. I started football when I was 17. My first team was Mahindra. So we used to know Khalid by then as a player. He was always joking around and doing stuff. But then when he became a coach, it was completely different. But like an elder brother, even in the under-19 team. And then getting promoted to the senior team. So, you know, so there have been good times, there have been bad times. But, you know, you learn from the experience. It's always, you gain experience, good or bad. Everything you do, you gain experience from it. So it was a great experience, you know, about the world, how the footballing world is. He was used to always call, you know, like an elder brother. After that, Owen Coyle's been amazing, man. Like, I've never worked under an English coach before, because I think there were two Spanish coaches. Oh, there was Steve Coppell. But because I came mid-season, we didn't... And Steve Coppell's not that involved with the players, how Owen is. Like, Steve Coppell was right at the top, Manchester United and Premiership and everything. But I didn't get to interact with him as much as with Owen Coyle. But Owen Coyle's, like, he'll give you so much confidence every day. He'll joke around. He'll be, like, one of those players, you know, he'll be there in training. He'll have fun in training. Like, there will be shooting contests or there will be finishing contests. Something. He's always involved. So it's been nice. And then it's always good, you know, because like how I'm saying something, what happens in Jamshedpur, he's giving me experience about what happened in his time in the Premiership when Sturridge was there or all these players who were there, you know, like for example. So he used to tell me, oh, this used to happen or that used to happen. And so it's nice, you know, I mean, you don't like I said, you know, like you if you're a normal guy, if you're a normal person, you won't get to chat around with Owen Coyle every day. So I've been, you know, grateful to like just have a conversation with him as well.
Absolutely. I mean, yeah, I mean, knowledge is power, right? And if you're learning anything, you're learning from the best. So Karan, though, I want to ask you though, does Karan Amin have any kind of, how do you say, pre-match rituals before a game? Anything in particular that you have to do before a game?
Pre-match ritual. So my body is really stiff. So I make it a priority to call my fiance because she's a physiotherapist. So now how we are having a Zoom call, we have a Zoom call and then we do a whole routine of stretching from sitting on the chair to stretching my glutes to my calves to my hamstrings. That's what I do always, and do a lot of breathing to just calm down before the game. And before the game, I am like the team DJ, you can say. So I'm always taking care of the music. So I'm always taking care of the music to lighten the mood. And there's the normal prayers and everything. But yeah, so all this is always there. My pre-match workout and everything.
Any particular genre of music that you like to play? Use Yourself by Eminem?
So there's Hindi, Punjabi, there's everything from Divine to everything. So you have everything. So I've got Tim hooked on Daru Badnam, two Spanish guys hooked on Daru Badnam. So nice. Tim knows about Divine songs. He knows, you know, he knows about everything. So he used to listen to that as well.
Great. And what would he normally do? I mean, if Karan Amin is just kicking back, relaxing, what does Karan Amin like to do when he's unwinding?
So I'm a big time gamer. I love to be on my PlayStation. Or if I'm home, like when I'm alone, I like to be on my PlayStation, play Call of Duty, FIFA or something. Or I have a small circle of friends who I always be with, like Jayesh and Ashutosh, and I have my old teammates and friends over there. So I make sure whenever I'm in Bombay, all these guys come over and we chill, we have food, we joke around. So my parents also, we all mingle around together. And so that's, whenever we're free, we try to play football in the evenings, like book a turf somewhere. We come to Bandra, we go here or there everywhere and just play around, you know, just to get fitness and fun.
Fair enough. And I mean, I'm sure, like I've already mentioned that there might be a modeling contract in for you soon. But if Karan Amin has to hang his boots, where do you see yourself going beyond football after that?
So I really love the sport. So I would love to be involved in the sport somehow. So I've done my licenses. I want to do a management course to understand more about the sport, not just football, all the sports. So you know how the functioning goes, how a club is run, or how what happens behind the scenes. So I would love to be in management as well. But right now, like I would love to be a coach, like and understand and give what knowledge I can give to people, because I think it's very important that people understand what professionalism is in football, or even the parents of kids to understand that there is a career in football, and not that, you know, you're gonna be on the road because you're gonna play football. If you are good, if you feel you're good, and you have a dream, I think you should pursue it, because not every day can you like earn after playing football. And I think people should pursue it more. The more people pursue it, the more growth will happen around. And there is abundant talent in India. And I'm not even gonna lie, in Mumbai specifically. But the only thing is, because of the hustle and bustle and the competition, somewhere along, some people have to leave football because of XYZ reasons. I myself know so many of my teammates who were probably better than me. I never know. But had to leave because of some financial issue or some problem at home. So I think that's very important for everyone to like not give up types. So I want kids to know it now. Like in my building, I always tell the kids who play in my building who are playing for academies and everything to keep pursuing, you know, because you never know what's going to happen.
Absolutely. So I mean,
that's there. I would love to be part of something, you know, even help out an NGO or anything, you know, like I know this Magic Bus does something like that, be involved. I know Darren does something with one team, Darren Caldera. So he does. So, you know, because I learned so much from him personally, because he's always been a guy who likes to give out whatever he knows. So, you know, it's always good to give back to the community you're from.
Well, before we go, before we conclude, Karan, I'd just like to ask though, what's the best piece of football advice that you've had or you'd like to give to your fans out there?
Best piece of advice is don't stop at anything and don't listen to anything. So it's like how in the pursuit of happiness, he tells him, you know, like, if you have a dream, just go achieve it types.
Yeah.
So just do that, man, because it will happen. It will happen. If you pursue something so badly and if you want it so badly, you'll get it somehow.
Well, that's some very, very wise words there, Karan. Again, thank you so much. This was a really, really lovely chat. I really appreciate having this discussion with you. For sure, for sure. For those watching at home as well, I hope you enjoyed this interview. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Check us out on Instagram as well. And this is Karl from All Balls. That was the wonderful Karan Amin. And we'll see you when we see you. Peace.
See you.